The following documents and recordings are the 15th installment in a compilation detailing the events of the repair team sent to Outpost Freestead, consisting of Dr. Rosa della Torre, Walter Heath, Graham Casner, Dr. Karina Schumacher-Weiss, and Jónas Thorisson. In the winter months, gale storms and Svalbard can reach wind speeds of 130 km per hour. Accompanied by or following snowfall, such storms can reduce visibility dramatically, more so in the winter months of the polar night. During these storms, travel is not advised. The White Vault. Installment, the team rushes to follow the trail of Mr. Walter Heath after he was dragged off in the white haze of the raging storm. This first recording is a continuation of the previous recording from Mr. Heath's hand recorder, which was dropped during his abduction.
This trail's still visible. Hurry!
Jónas! Jónas! I know you're confused! But I need you to follow me!
Reattach him to the rope. It got severed when we split. Quickly!
What's that?
You're fine. The cut is not deep. The duct tape will seal up the hole in the paneling to conserve your trapped body heat. Jónas! Jónas! This way! We have to go!
The polar bear may come back. Stay close. I see his trail.
Fuck the polar bear! That monster took Walter!
Walter, I have his recorder!
What, Jónas? I can't hear you!
I have the recorder! He dropped it!
Just keep up! The slower we go, the more likely we'll lose the trail. This storm will wipe it away in minutes.
I heard it! He's still alive!
Shit!
What's wrong? He's alive!
The trail's getting weaker. Everyone hurry!
Earlier. I'm sorry for my actions. I cost us valuable time. It's my hand that hurts.
Did you land on it in your fall?
Rosa, look.
Blood.
Just a bit.
But it's not frozen.
We're not far behind. We may still catch him.
But I do not hear Walter.
We know Karina struck her head several times being dragged this way. He may have as well.
Here, look.
Get back behind me.
No, look. Here. It's his.
Don't get ahead of me. We don't need you getting grabbed.
Is the shotgun loaded?
Yes.
I heard him.
Keep up.
The recording continues like that for a while, over an hour, as they descend into the caves toward the town under the ice, pursuing Mr. Heath and his abductor. The following short section of a journal entry was written by Dr. Della Torre in regards to the events that have transpired thus far.
Caminamos tanto tiempo en medio de la tormenta. Siguiendo cada paso que Grey andaba, era muy difícil ver a nuestra. We had walked for so long out into the storm, following Graham with every step. It was hard to see anything, least of all our way back home. It all happened so fast after that. One moment there was a tug at the line, the next Jónas was in the air. We were all hauled through the snow, inhaling frigid dust, and faced with the possibility of being lost in a bank so deep there would be no way out. The light of the flare gave us a point of orientation, but it was only a brief reprieve. Jónas hit the ground, and the pool stopped. Then the bear came, seeing us as a bright choice prey in our bulky, brilliantly colored winter jackets. As it rushed us, we jumped from its path, but somehow, in the confusion, our line was severed. Walter disappeared into the white, gone in moments. Not the polar bear, not the mundane dangers of this place, but that horrible something I cannot explain. We followed after Walter. Within moments, his trail could have disappeared into the storm winds, but we did not hesitate. But we were back at the auxiliary bunker in minutes. Having walked so far into the storm, hours, it was impossible. Impossible we had not left the vicinity. Impossible to return so quickly. Impossible to reach Walter. Impossible to get home. It was torture. I could hear him every half hour or so, following his calls, Walter screaming. We knew he was alive as we rushed through white storms and black caverns. I feared everything.
Now, this recording is a continuation of the previous group recording from Mr. Heath's recorder, now in the possession of Mr. Thorison.
Is this really the best idea? We know what happened to Karina.
Heath's alive. We can hear him.
We're nearly there. Just 100 more meters or so.
100 more meters or so of what? Until we find another heart? Until we face that thing again? Nothing this way is going to help us. We should try again. To leave. Or we should go back to the bunker. Shoot off the remaining flares, turn on the personal locator, and wait everything out.
I'm not waiting around to die of starvation.
And I will not give up on Walter.
You're going to get me killed.
We're here. They're back.
The statues.
They aren't even where they were before. It's a path.
It's a trap.
The rope is still here.
It took it down last time. Why are we whispering? It knows we're here. Look at the statues. It's a fucking promenade to that hellish place.
If you want to turn around, do it. But...
Quiet. I saw something move. In a window of the theater. That one.
I don't see anything.
It's not there anymore. It just passed by. Rosa, take this. I'm climbing down.
Give it here. Hurry! All right, I'm coming down. Your choice to follow or not, Jónas.
I just wanna go home. I'm coming down. Hurry up!
You got all the
cramps.
Stay close. Weapons out. Don't shoot or swing unless you know it's not Heath.
Do you think it will be there?
What?
A heart.
A new one. Walter's.
We'll soon find out.
So many more statues than before.
Last time, I only saw three, maybe four. I count at least 12 now, and I don't recognize some of these animals.
Just stay together and don't touch anything. We are nearly there.
That one looks like a rhinoceros. Look at the horn.
I'd rather not.
I'll go first. Jónas, keep an eye out behind us as I go through. Follow through quickly after. No separation.
Do you see him? Through the rocks? Anything? A box? Blood? Walter?
Nothing. The fresh heart and the coffee tin, both gone. Come through, Rosa.
So, something took them, like Karina and Walter. Walter may still be alive.
Something moved. Rosa, hurry. Please hurry.
I got you. She's out. Hurry, though. I'll watch behind you, but stay low.
Impossible. ¿Qué está pasando? It's gone. All the blood.
Is there a trail? Are we still going the right way? Should we leave?
Help, Rosa, please.
Walter!
Walter!
Is that you?
Where are you?
I'm stuck. Rosa, grab my hand.
Here. Hold tight. Now, get your flare gun out. Hurry.
It came from everywhere. The tracks. The tracks are gone. They only led into here.
What if it's not? It could be that thing. It was Karina, yes? So it could be Walter.
Rosa!
Jónas, help me!
Take the shot!
Get down! Shit!
You prefer to be stopped by us?
No.
Fuck!
Jónas, I just... on into my leg in the wall.
You're bleeding. I need to check your leg.
No, let's get out of here first. This is neither the time nor the place. Jónas, head back out. We're leaving.
Not this way.
Don't mess around. Get moving.
The cave entry. It's collapsed.
It can't be. Move. I want to see.
Fastur hérna. Don't take it for fun.
Statues, they surrounded the cave entrance. And he's right. It's gone.
I just want to see them. Stelpur mínar.
The following recording is one of a few small recordings found on Mr. Graham Casner's cell phone. Unlike the advanced phones of several other team members, his phone is an older model flip phone. It has this recorded message on it, though quality is naturally poor due to the subpar quality of the phone's recording abilities.
Rosa, how's the leg look?
Painful, but you didn't cut anything too important. Well, aside from some muscle, I'm going to start stitching it up. I'm warning you. I'm doing this fast and it will hurt.
Just hurry. The earthquake, or whatever the hell that was, may have stopped, but something is still out there and we are falling.
You said hurry. I wasn't going to wait for you to stop talking. Keep doing your recording thing.
Hours into our hike, into the storm, we were assaulted by a bear, and by whatever demon haunts us here. Walter Heath was taken, and we followed the faint trail as far as here, the anatomical theater, beneath the ice. But the trail has faded. There was an earthquake or something, maybe... Maybe an ice fall. The cave we used to get here has collapsed, so leaving that way may not be enough.
That should be enough. It's sealed and clean. Keep it wrapped and patch up the hole to keep your body heat in.
We need to get moving. Wait, Jónas, what's that by your foot?
What are you looking at?
It looks like a leather strap.
It's not Walter's. He had a modern synthetic pack.
No. It's not his. It's old. Old leather, rusted metal buckles. Looks like it's from...
World War II. On the pocket, a patch from the war. Can't place it, though.
Open it!
Mostly empty. Oh, a can! No label, but it may be food. Rope. Cigarette case. A journal? I can't read this. I don't even know what language this is.
Help! Someone, please!
Not like this!
it moving. Grab anything useful.
I believe the journal they found in the World War II era pack was that which I'll read to you now. The journal was relatively well preserved, but there was very little written to begin with, and no indication of a name for the writer. This is a section of the translation from the original Finnish.
Olen todellinen tyhmyri. Olisipa Jumala antanut minulle enemmän tunnetta kuin velvollisuutta. Sota oli loppunut ja ryntäsin mahdollisiin työtarjouksiin ennen kuin edes ajattelin. Mitä se... I am such a fool. Worried that God had blessed me with more sense than duty. The war was over and I jumped that opportunity to stay employed before I even thought of what it could mean. Harald got a job at the cod catcher boat. Just a few weeks after I got this, I should have gone with him. After it all, though, I could never live my life and call myself a fisherman. I'm a born soldier in a world where soldiers are just sickening reminders of the past. I'd never heard of this place. Now I'm going to die here. I cannot feel much. The cold keeps the pain at bay. All this for some information, because this war is never over. We found the station, the three Norwegians, our Brit and I. We found the papers the Germans swore they'd burned. In the end, we ended up burning them. Not a lot out there to keep you warm or fed. I can feel it now, in a way. My legs are numb, my chest feels concave. My stomach is warm, a puddle of rolling tar. It took Lunde, ripped him right off from me. I took Chase back down here to this hell. One bad length of rope, and at once I was stuck up on a stalagmite. So simple a thing. Potatoes on a skewer. At least I've stolen the opportunity of killing me from those monstrous devils. If they want my heart, they'll have to find it. Cold and lifeless. I like to think I did the right thing, not marrying Pinja. Fine girl, but I'd never had made her happy wife. Even dying out here would have broken her heart. Not knowing what happened, no one will know. Maybe one of these Norwegians had connections. Maybe they'll come looking. I'll be a corpse by then, not worth the time to look for. I found some scrimshaw earlier. Real craftsman quality on one side, carving of a whale. The other side was all jumble. Looked like quick attempt at carving Russian. I only speak it, I can't read it. My life was a gift from God, and in a pursuit of honor on this earth, I forsook his laws. I have taken thy name in vain, Lord. I have lied and stolen, cursed and fornicated. Above all, I have taken up arms against my fellow man and struck them down. I have killed in the name of country against the word of God. In my final hours, I ask for forgiveness to rise from my squalid existence, to rise to your grace and comforts. Lord, please forgive me.
This concludes those documents related to the team's attempt to track down Mr. Walter Heath and his abductor. This completes the 15th collection of information regarding the repair team at Outpost Freestead. The White Vault.